Hi everyone, welcome to the second episode of Cupertino Chat App series. In this episode, we are going to create a Firebase project, we are going to configure a Firebase emulator, and we are going to use Firebase Firestore in the Flutter app. Without further ado, let's get started. On the last episode, we did the four buttons on the tab bar, and we assign a simple text in the middle for each tab. Everything that I'm going to teach here for episode 2, it works for macOS, Windows or Linux. I'm using macOS and I'll be using iOS emulator. We need to have Node.js installed on the machine to be able to use npm. You can follow the link to install Node for macOS or for Windows. I will leave the link in the description. After having installed Node.js, we need to install the Firebase CLI, and can install using the Node package, using npm install -g Firebase tools, or you can use other means of installing the Firebase CLI on the Firebase CLI official website. I will leave this link on the description as well. You can follow to install for Windows, macOS or Linux using the CLI to log into our Firebase account. And for that, I will type on the terminal Firebase login. And it will pop up a browser where you can select your Google account in which you want to use the Firebase CLI. After selecting the account, it asks if you want to trust the Firebase CLI, click allow, and you're gonna receive a successful login message. Close, go back to the terminal, and you see here success login as and your email. Let's log in to our Firebase console on the browser and create our Firebase project for this application. console.firebase.google.com. It will ask you to log in with a Google account. Select a Google account and you'll land on this page. If you have already a project created, it will show up here a project where you can select the project and configure. In this case, I don't have any project for now. Click on create a project, enter the project name. I will just put chat app. Accept the Firebase terms and continue. Enable Google Analytics for this project. I will deselect that, create a project. When the project is created, it shows here a message, your new project is ready. Click continue to go to the project. Here we are. We are on the dashboard of the chat app project. On the left, you have options to configure your application, and we can add applications to associate to this project. We can associate an iOS or a macOS. If you are using Flutter, iOS works as well for macOS, Android or a web. Click on iOS to add an iOS application for your project. It asks the iOS bundle ID. I go to Xcode. I have here my project. I click on the runner and I can see here the bundle identifier for my iOS application. I copy the bundle identifier, I go back to Firebase and I paste it here. I register the app. It will generate a Google service info. Build this file and we're gonna import this file into Xcode. I will download, it's still loading. I click next. It shows here guides how to configure Firebase for iOS. But in this case, we're gonna use Flutter to configure Firebase for iOS or Android. Skip everything, click next. Skip the initialization code, next, continue to console. If you are using Android emulator, you can do add app and select Android and do the same thing. On the left, build, and I will select Firestore database. I will create database and I will select start in test mode. Next, it shows the location. I will select Europe, enable. It's creating the Cloud Firestore instance. Now I have my Cloud Firestore instance. At this point, I have the Firebase CLI installed on my machine. I have the Firebase project created. I associated an app to Firebase project and created the Firestore database. The next step is we configure our source code to use the Firebase. On the terminal, in the same directory where I have my application, my Flutter app, I write Firebase in it. I will select Firestore with the space. I will select functions. It's something that you're gonna use later in this tutorial series, and emulators. We are going to use the Firestore and authentication from the emulator instead using the Firestore instance created. We have selected the Firestore functions and emulator. Click enter. We can select creating a new Firebase project or using an existing project. We already created a project. For this particular case, I will just select use an existing project. I have only one project associated to this Google account. So for now, I will select all the default setup for this, click enter. And for the cloud functions, I will select TypeScript. I don't want to enforce ESLint. I want to install dependencies, NPM dependencies, to be able to write cloud functions on Firebase. Ask now which Firebase emulator that I want to set up. Authenticator emulator, functions emulator, and Firestore. Click on enter. It asks me the ports that I want to run the Firebase emulator, Auth emulator, Firestore, and Cloud Functions emulator. I will just select enter to keep all the default value. Enter default for Auth emulator, enter default for functions emulator port, and default for Firestore emulator port. And if I want to enable the UI, yes, of course. And for the port, I will just select a default port. To download the emulator, I will select yes. I want to download the Firebase emulator. The Firebase initialization is completed. Let's go to our source code. On pubspec YAML, we need to add some dependencies to be able to use Firebase services. The first dependency I will add is not related to Firebase, is Cupertino listout. We're gonna see that later on this episode. Then I will add these three dependencies: Firebase Core, Cloud Firestore, Firebase Authentication, and Cloud Functions. And I do Flutter pub get. To continue with the configuration of the Firebase services on Flutter, I'm using the Flutter Fire guide, official guide from Flutter. I will put this link in the description below. We already added the dependencies on pubspec YAML. We already did Flutter pub get, and it has platform setup guides for Android, iOS, macOS, and web. For iOS, we need to add this command inside the pod file so that we don't need to compile on our local machine and save time. So I go back to the source code, I open the iOS folder, and I click pod file. I scroll down until I see target runner 2 and paste it here after Flutter install. On the top, I will add this variable, Firebase SDK version 850. Let's save the file. We need to add to our runner the Google services that we downloaded. On the Xcode, I click on runner, file, add files to runner. Now I have these Google services attached to the runner. Now, back to the Flutter project, I will start the Firebase emulator. Go to the terminal, I will run Firebase emulators start to start the Firebase emulator. And the emulator is started. The emulator UI started on the port 4001, authentication on 9099, functions 5001, and Firestore 8089. I open the Firebase UI and I can have access to all the users that are authenticated to my app and the Firestore. I will keep this tab open. Now let's make our Flutter app connecting to the Firebase Firestore and get data from the Firestore. I will go to main.dart file. On the very top, on the main method, I have to call is widgets, Flutter binding ensure initialized. I need to call an await and initialize Firebase app. Firebase initialize. I have to import Firebase core, and the main is an async function and returns a future. We need to configure our Firebase object, our Firebase service, to use the emulator instead the Cloud Firebase. For that, I will create another method that is a future method that will be connect to Firebase emulator. It's an async method. Returns a future. I will create two variables, Firebase store port and authentication port. Let's go back to the terminal, Firebase, and here authentication 9099 and Firestore 8089. I will define another variable that will be localhost. I have to import the platform dart.io. If we are using the Android emulator, our localhost is 10022. If we are using iOS emulator, the localhost is referred by localhost itself. Then we configure the Firebase Firestore settings to use the emulator. So I paste here Firebase Firestore instance settings equals settings, and I pass the host that will be the string localhost and the Firestore port. I will set the SSL enabled to force and persistence enabled to force. I have an arrow here settings because I have a widget here down the line that is settings widget. There is a conflict between the settings widget and the settings class from Firestore. What I will do to simplify, I will go to screens, I will open the settings screen, and I rename this class refactor the name to settings screen. Close, I go back to mine. We need to initialize the Firebase out to use the emulator as well. I do await Firebase out instance use emulator, and I provide the localhost and the port. I have now the Firebase services configured on Flutter. I need to call the connect to Firebase emulator here. Now my app is always using the Firebase emulator. I can create a variable here, use emulator, and choose whenever I want to use the emulator or not. I do if use emulator. If I set to false, it will use the Cloud Firestore. I will run the app to see if everything is okay. We have our application run successfully, so we can access all the screens. And by seeing the logs, we don't have any errors on the log, so everything works as expected. To finalize this episode, we are going to display dummy data from the Firestore database into our application. Let's go, for instance, to chat screen. Instead of returning a container, I will return a custom crawl view and expect slivers, a list of widgets. The first one, I will just return a sliver list. I will provide the sliver child list delegate. Inside the silver list delegate that expects an array of widgets, first item that is a Cupertino list style. I have to import it, import package Cupertino list style, and I will add another one, another item from my list that will be SHA-2, and third one SHA-2. Let's go to our shots, and we see here the three lists. Our custom scroll view receives silver list, and before that we can add another view that will represent the navigation bar. I will provide a Cupertino sliver navigation bar, and the Cupertino sliver navigation bar expects a large title, and I will provide the text widget with the text shots, and we see the shots in our navigation bar. Let's go to our Firebase emulator. On the Firestore, I will create a collections. For instance, let's say shots. Next, I will create the first collection title, and I will put message one, save, and it will create a document, shots document, with this ID. This document has a title field with message one, and I will create another document with the title field message two. Now I have two documents, document one and document two. On the chat screen in Flutter, I will do a query for this chats collection and get all the documents. Here on the chat screen, instead of returning a custom scroll view, I will return stream builder and the stream builder of type query snapshot, and the builder receives a builder. The first parameter is a build context, context, and the second one will be a sync snapshot of the type query snapshot. The argument name is snapshot. The stream builder also receives a stream, and the stream will be our Firebase Firestore instance, and we query for the collection. The collection is shots collection, and we get the snapshots. On the builder, we need to parse a callback function. We return container. So basically, our shot screen will return a stream builder, and this stream builder will do a stream to our Firebase Firestore instance and read all the shots documents, and the builder will build widgets and return the snapshot, the result of this query. If snapshot has errors, I will return a text that will indicate there is an error. Return center child text, and the text will be something went wrong. If snapshot.connection state equals connection state dot waiting, I will return loading. If snapshot has data, I will return custom scroll view. So the first sliver is our navbar, and the second sliver will be the list view, sliver list. And the sliver list receives a sliver list child delegate, this one, sliver child delegate, that expects an array of widgets. We need to provide the parameter name, delegate, expects a sliver shadow delegate. If we have data, we return a custom scroll view, which return all the view, including the Cupertino sliver navigation bar and the sliver list. We provide a list of Cupertino list style. But this list is provided by the data. So we need to map the data into widgets. It expects a list snapshot.data. I will take the data from the snapshots, read all the docs, and map all the docs. So the map expects document snapshot and a callback function. Then I will convert that into a list. For now, I will return a container. So what happens? I'm transforming the data from the snapshot, is document, I'm returning for container. And this map will contain information from document, and I will convert this map into a list. That is the list silver list expects. And what I will return instead of a container, I will return a Cupertino list style. For the title, I will provide a text. And from the document, we're gonna get the date. A document is a map of key values. I will get a map from the document. I will create another variable, map string and dynamic. The value can be anything, and it will be data that equals to document.data. On the text, I will provide the data, the key title like this. Because the document one, I have key title, document two, I have key title as well. And run the code. And I saw the loading message, and I see message one and message two. On the left, now I have the Firebase Firestore console. I will add a new document, and it will automatically reflect on the app. The app is listening, is a stream, and each time the database is updated, it will update the app. So let's add a new document, title, and got message 3, save, adds, new document, title, messages 4, save, adds.
That's all about Firestore integration in Flutter. In the next episode, we are going to build the UI for the phone authentication. If you like this video, give us a like, share, don't forget to subscribe. Thank you for watching. See you next time.